Astoria, John Jacob Astor and Thomas Jefferson's Lost Pacific Empire, by Peter Stark is a gripping narrative that delves into the audacious vision and subsequent failure of the American Fur Company's Pacific fur trade venture in the early 19th century. Stark meticulously reconstructs this fascinating episode of American history, weaving together the threads of ambition, exploration, and hardship that characterized this ill-fated enterprise. Through vivid storytelling and extensive research, Stark not only brings to life the individuals involved but also illuminates the broader historical context of American expansionism during this period. The book's title itself hints at the convergence of two titanic figures in American history, John Jacob Astor and Thomas Jefferson. Astor, a German immigrant turned millionaire, is portrayed as a shrewd and ambitious entrepreneur who sought to capitalize on the lucrative fur trade in the Pacific Northwest. Thomas Jefferson, on the other hand, represents the intellectual and political backdrop against which Astor's ambitions unfolded. Jefferson's vision of westward expansion, encapsulated in the Lewis and Clark expedition, provides the ideological foundation for Astor's grand design. Stark skillfully navigates the complexities of the fur trade, painting a vivid picture of the harsh conditions and intense competition that characterized this industry. He introduces readers to a cast of characters, from seasoned fur trappers like Alexander Ross to the ambitious explorers Wilson Price Hunt and Robert Stuart. These individuals, each with their own motivations and quirks, play crucial roles in Astor's grand plan to establish a fur trading post at the mouth of the Columbia River. One of the book's strengths lies in its portrayal of the daunting challenges faced by Astor's expedition. Stark vividly describes the treacherous journey undertaken by Hunt's overland party, which endured starvation, hostile encounters with Native American tribes, and the unforgiving wilderness of the Rocky Mountains. This narrative serves as a testament to the indomitable spirit of exploration and the human will to survive against all odds. Stark also explores the complex interactions between the fur traders and indigenous peoples of the Pacific Northwest. He highlights the diverse cultures and languages encountered by the expedition, emphasizing the importance of diplomacy and trade in their interactions. The book does not shy away from addressing the conflicts and misunderstandings that arose between the fur traders and Native American tribes, shedding light on the complexities of cultural exchange and exploitation inherent in the fur trade. The narrative takes a dramatic turn when Astor's plan to establish a fortified fur trading post, known as Fort Astoria, encounters challenges on multiple fronts. From British competitors to the War of 1812, the enterprise faces a barrage of setbacks. Stark meticulously details the series of events that culminate in the eventual sale of Fort Astoria to the Northwest Company, a rival British fur trading company. This outcome underscores the geopolitical forces at play in the Pacific Northwest during this period and the vulnerability of American interests in the region. Stark's writing is engaging and evocative, immersing the reader in the rugged landscapes and perilous journeys undertaken by the characters. He skillfully interweaves historical records, personal accounts, and his own observations, creating a narrative that feels both well-researched and emotionally resonant. Moreover, the author's exploration of the broader historical context, including the Lewis and Clark expedition, for trade economics, and geopolitical rivalries, adds depth and richness to the story. In conclusion, Astoria, John Jacob Astor and Thomas Jefferson's Lost Pacific Empire, by Peter Stark is a masterful work of historical narrative that illuminates a lesser-known chapter of American history. Through meticulous research and compelling storytelling, Stark brings to life the grand ambitions, formidable challenges, and ultimate failure of Astor's Pacific fur trade venture. In doing so, he provides a window into the broader historical forces shaping America's westward expansion and the encounters between Native American cultures and European American enterprise. This book is a captivating read for anyone interested in the intersection of exploration, entrepreneurship, and American frontier history.